This is Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to discuss the automobile steering geometry. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to explain automobile steering geometry. In this particular session, we are going to discuss what is steering geometry and different types of steering geometries. Now, before discussing this topic, we will see what is mean by automobile steering geometry. Please think, students, what is steering geometry? We'll see. It is the relationship of the angles among the front wheels, front wheel attaching parts, and ground. First one, the steering geometry is the camber. Camber is the inward or outward tilt of wheels from vertical when viewed from the front of the vehicle. Camber is measured in degrees. On vehicle, positive camber is adjusted initially. So, when vehicle is loaded and rolling along the road surface, vehicle should run straight up and down with zero camber. This puts the full width of the tire tread on the road surface, which is desirable. However, it is difficult to obtain a zero camber. The camber goes negative when tire hits the bump and goes positive when falls in a pothole. This is caused by unequal length control arms of the suspension system. In any camber, either positive or negative causes uneven tire wear. So ideally, camber should be zero, which is somewhat difficult. So initially, negative camber is provided. Now next one is caster. What is meant by caster? It is the tilt of steering axis towards the front or rear of the vehicle. If the tilt is towards the front, it is taken as negative, and when it is towards the rear, taken as positive. Usually, positive caster is provided to the vehicle. Caster is measured in degrees. Caster angle adjustment is for some feasibility. So, first one is to maintain directional stability and control, to increase steering returnability, and to reduce steering effort. This requirement can be met by providing positive caster. Vehicles with power steering have more positive caster than with manual steering. However, the more positive caster requires more steering effort, which is not felt due to power steering. Any decrease in positive caster than required causes spring sagging. Next one, that is steering axis inclination, that is also called as kingpin inclination. First of all, we'll see what is steering axis. It is the line passing through centers of ball joints. It is the axis around which a front wheel swings for steering. It is the angle between vertical line and steering axis. It is the inward tilt of the steering axis from vertical as viewed from the front. This inward tilt is desirable because of some of the reason. It helps in returning the steering wheel to straight ahead after completing a turn and keeps the vehicle in stable condition. This is called as steering returnability. It helps in reducing steering effort, especially when vehicle is not moving, and also reduces tire wear. Steering axis inclination cannot be adjusted because it depends on geometry of knuckle. Usually it is correct, but when it is not within the specification, the spindle, steering knuckle, ball joint, and other dependent parts wear or bend down. This is indication of a wrong steering axis inclination. In this, we'll see what is curb radius. In this particular figure, we have shown a distance between this particular a ball joint and the tire, that will give you a scrub radius. This term scrub radius is defined as, it is the distance between steering axis and tire contact area center line as their intersection with road surface. If the steering axis intersect the road surface inside the tire center line, scrub radius is positive. If that intersection point is outside the center line of the tire, it is negative. Zero scrub radius means steering axis and tire axis meet at ground surface exactly. Scrub radius is not an alignment angle and usually cannot be directly measured. However, it is directly affects steering stability. Steering effort and steering return ability. Rear drive vehicles with unequal length front suspension control arm often have positive scrub radius, while front drive vehicles with MacPherson strut from suspension have negative scrub radius. Next one, that is toe in, toe out. What is meant by toe in, toe out? It is the measurement of how much the wheels point in or out from the straight ahead position. It is measured in mm, inches or in degrees. Ideally, running toe must be zero. When the wheel points inwards, it is toe in, and when wheel point outwards, it is toe out. Zero toe means the wheels run parallel. They are at same distance apart at in front as well as in rear. Any toe in or toe out drags the tire sideways as it rolls. The greater the toe angle, faster the tire wear. Next one we'll see. In this also we'll discuss the suspension height that is not mentioned over here. What is suspension height? It is the distance measured from some specific point of the body, frame or suspension to the ground. It is not adjusted correctly. It can affect wheel alignment. Incorrect height can affect from sagging coil or leaf spring. Incorrect torsion bar adjustment. Now next one we'll see, that is the turning radius. What is turning radius? It is the difference in the angles of the front wheels in turn, also called as toe out on turn or turning angle. During a turn, the two front wheels travel on concentric circles, having common centers. The inner wheel run through greater angle, while outer run through a smaller one. So as the distance is greater from outer wheel and small for inner wheel. If turning radius is incorrect, check for the bend in steering arm or a tie rod. Now next one is the included angle. Included angle, it is the addition of camber angle and steering axis inclination. Together it will form an included angle. It is not an adjustable angle. However, an improper included angle often indicates a bend in spindle or strut. Now next one is setback. What is setback? Wheel setback is the difference in vehicle wheelbase from one side to other. It occurs when one wheel is behind the other on same axle. Setback occurs from production tolerances during vehicle manufacturing or from impact damage. It also occurs because of improper placement of engine or subframe. A vehicle with drift or pull towards the side with shorter wheelbase, setback more than 19 mm is excessive, indicates bent in parts. Now last one is, that is the thrust angle. Here you can see in this figure what is the thrust angle. When the wheel is properly aligned, it should move in a straight line. But if rear of vehicle has improper setback, it may not move straight ahead. The direction of travel is determined by three lines, that is run the length of vehicle. Vehicle center line is the line passing through center of the vehicle body. This line should be the same as the geometric centerline of the vehicle that connects the midpoints of front wheels and rear wheels. The thrust line is a line from the midpoint between the two rear wheels. Now, these are the references. Thank you.